Hello. We are the Midwest Fora. We are a group of young people who are impaired. In this short video, we will share with you our impaired experiences. We hope you can relate to our stories and that these will be of benefit to you.
It was a Thursday. I remember that. How could I forget the day that I was put into care? Of all the details of that day, it's the one that always comes to mind first. It was a Thursday. Then the other details come back. It was drizzling rain. You could see the rain settle on the shoulders of all the social workers standing outside our house. I remember thinking, thank God it's not lashing or we'd all be drowned. I was wearing my PE gear because I didn't change after class, just came home as I was. I was surprised to see the cars outside our house. I was surprised, but I wasn't shocked. I knew. I knew from up the street what was going to happen. I remember just looking around at all the action, a bit like slow motion. I saw them knocking on the door, our door.
I saw our neighbour Mary across the street come out as far as her front gate. I saw two magpies sweeping past the Lawler's house, four doors down. I saw a white car and a red car parked outside our house. I didn't think, I was just watching like it was a movie. It didn't feel real. It was so strange, and when I think about it now, it feels like it was a movie with me in it. If it was a movie, what kind of movie would it be? I've often wondered that. I do know that after that day, everything changed. Everything was completely different. My life, it was never going to be the same again. That Thursday that everything changed.
It's so funny because people say that I look like her all the time, everywhere we go. Oh Mary, she's the spit out of ya. You're the image of your mother. She's a pure head off ya. Sometimes I look at her and think, do I look like her? Am I the cut out of her? Then I have to remind myself that I couldn't be like her because we're not at all related, me and Mary. My mum. She is my foster mother, though I never call her foster mother. Hello foster mother, any chance I could have some credit for my phone? Good evening foster mother, is it possible for you not to turn off the Wi-Fi until after 9 o'clock? Can you imagine? She's not my foster mother. Well, she's just my mam. That's it really. It's as simple and as complicated as that. You see, I've lived here with my family since I was 3, and they are my family. I act like them, I talk like them. Some people say I even look like them. But I have another family that I see sometimes, and it's a really shit position to be in when you feel like you're cheating on one family with another. I love my other family, the ones that people call my real family, but I don't know them. I don't belong to them the way I feel I belong here. I don't know why I should feel guilty, but I do. I hope that I look like Mary because she is my mother and this is my family.
I've never told anyone in school that I'm in care. Never. And I really don't want people finding out either. I don't know why. I'm in care since I was a child. I'm not going anywhere. I will live with my mom and dad until... Well, you know, until I go to college and I get my own place. And I can't wait. But there's no big secret. No big drama. I am just in care. My mother couldn't look after me. And I understand that now. I'm loved by my mother, my mom and my dad, and yet I would die if anyone found out about me being like a foster child. I was thinking about it the other day. What am I so afraid of? I think I'm afraid of people changing how they see me. Now, they look at me and say, hey, there's Jessica. She loves sports and music and she is really funny and is good at school. I don't want them to start thinking, I wonder what happened to her. I wonder why she's in care. I wonder what her mother did. And the worst part is, I don't want them to start judging my mother, thinking she was a bad person because she couldn't look after me, that she abandoned me. I don't want them to pity me and think of me differently. You see, I know my own story and I am really okay with it. But sometimes I don't think other people could be okay with it and judge me or pity me or look at me differently. Do you look at me differently? Can you see just Jessica that loves playing sports and music and is funny and is good at school? Will you let me be?
No.
Words. Do you know all those words, do ya? Bet you don't. What about you? Oh, you do, yeah? Well, what about review? Do you know what a review is? You don't. Don't be messing. You see, that's one of the first things you have to learn when you come into care. There's a whole new language, and if you don't know it, you can't speak it. See, things like social worker. It does sound like they're working hard at being social, but it's not like that at all. In fact, the social workers are not into anything that's go crack at all. They're into safety and risk and not putting yourself at risk, not being exposed to risk, not being in risky situations, risk management, risk assessment. Yeah, they're mad about risk. Now, if you ask me, I thought risk was balancing on the edge of the rooftop on my skateboard in high winds. But seemingly, there's more to it than that. And like all these other mad words, like assessment, never in my life did I hear that word before I came into care. And I would hear it all the time. Assessment of needs, psychological assessment, educational assessment. I must be the most assessed girl in the world. But I kind of like this new language now that I know it. Like, I can use it to my advantage. I got a new social worker there a while back, and she comes in to me very nice and all, and she gave me the big talk. And at the end she says to me, "Do you think we can work together?" And I says, "Very smooth. I don't know. I'll have to wait for the outcome of the assessment."
Ben is so annoying, he really is. I know he's my younger brother, but like he used to follow me around all the time. Every time I opened the bathroom door, he was standing there, waiting for me. He gets home from school earlier than me too, and no sooner would I have the door opened or my bag thrown down than he would be there with that Lego that he loves, wanting me to build something with him. He's so different than me. He sings all the time, like literally every second. He loves that red haired twat, you know, like with the glasses, you know who I'm talking about. All the girls say he's good looking, but if he went to our school instead of being a celebrity, not one of them would look at him. Anyway, he sings him all the time. I'm on my way, driving at 90 down those country lights. No, I can't wait to go home. He always sings that song. His favorite now, I think it's Sick, but he loves ice cream and crisps mashed in together like a big ball of puke. That's what it looks like and smells worse, but he loves it. His idea of heaven, me and him, a massive box of Lego and bowls of ice cream and crisps, other night PJs, and all day to do just that. And that's what we used to do before, just me and him, every hour of every day. But I don't live with him anymore, because when we were taken into care, they couldn't find a place for the two of us because I'm so much older. So now we live in different places. But did you know that there are 160 hours in a week? 160, that's a lot, isn't it? I only get to see Ben for 2 hours. 2 hours out of 168. So spend the other 166 wondering, is there anyone making love with him? Is he singing that song? Is he alone? Is he okay?